Hello everyone, I am Gerald Martel. My part for our report is Philippine mythology. Philippine mythology has been handed down primarily through the traditional oral folk literature and preserved through the aid of community spiritual leaders or shamans such as Babaylan, Katalunan, Mombaki, Baglan, Machanito, Walian, Mangubat, Bahasa, etc., and community elders. Philippine mythology attempts to explain the nature of the world through the lives and actions of deities such as gods, goddesses, heroes, and mythological creatures. Philippine mythology mostly consists of creation stories or stories about supernatural creatures such as the aswang, the manananggal, the diwata or encanto, and nature. Some popular figures from Philippine mythologies are Maria Makiling, Lamang, and the Sari Manok. Philippine mythology shows influence from various sources, having similarities with Indonesian and Malay myths, as well as Hindu, Muslim, Buddhist, and Christian traditions, such as the notion of heaven, kaluwalhatian, kalangitan, kamurayawan, etc. The notion of hell, kasamaan, sulad, etc. And the notion of human soul, kaluluwa, kaululan, etc. Philippine mythologies and indigenous religions have historically been referred as anitism, meaning ancestral religion. Today, many ethnic peoples continue to practice and conserve their unique indigenous religions. Specific communities throughout the Philippines also adhere to anitism, while more than 90% of Philippine national population continue to believe in certain anitist belief system. Most anitism, indigenous religions, and shamanisms in the Philippines in the modern days are melted with Christianity. That is my part. Again, I am Gerald Martel. Thanks for watching.
Hi there everyone. My name is John Cedric I. Mercado. I'm a second year BPED student and I'm here to discuss to you the festival in the Philippines. Let's start. Festivals in the Philippines. So, festivals in the Philippines, locally known as fiestas, originated dating back to the Spanish colonial period when the Spaniards introduced Christianity to the country. Festivals. A festival is an event ordinarily celebrated by the community and centering on some characteristics, aspects of the community and its religion or cultures. Here are the top 8 festivals in the Philippines. This video was made by the YouTube channel Mylis. Special thanks to them. First is the Ati-Atihan Festival in Calibo, Aklan. It is a feast to honor the Santo Niño or Infant Jesus. It is held every third Sunday of January. It is known as the mother of all Philippine festivals. Because it inspired many other Philippine festivals. Next is the Sinulog Festival, held in Cebu City. An annual cultural and religious festival held also on the third Sunday of January. It is considered to be the most popular festivals in the Philippines, attracting around 1 to 2 million people every year. Just wow. The word sinulog comes from the Cebuano adverb sulog, which roughly means like water current movement. It describes the forward and backward movement of the sinulog dance. It brings together gifted residents of the city and the provinces beyond showcase their talents. Through pageantry, street dancing, sports, and other acts. The next one is the Dinagyang Festival in Iloilo City, held on the fourth Sunday of January, or right after the Sinulog in Cebu and the Atiatian Festival in Calibo, Aklan. Streets are usually closed during this festival with bands playing in every corner. Different tribes come together in this festival, with each making entertaining presentations. Voted as the best tourism event 3 times in a row among any other festival in the Philippines. It is also the most awarded festival in the country because of its legacy, popularity, and innovation. The next is Panagbenga Festival in Baguio City. This festival held for a whole month of February. Panagbenga comes from a Kankei word meaning season of blooming. Created as a tribute to the city's flowers and as a way to rise up from the devastation of the 1990 Luzon earthquake. The festival includes floats that are covered with flowers and street dancing presented by dancers clad in flower-inspired costumes. Aside from boosting the economy through tourism, it also helped the younger generation of indigenous people to rediscover their culture's old traditions. Many activities were also celebrated on the duration of the month. The next is Moriones Festival in Marinduque Province, a Lenten rites held annually on a Holy Week on the island of Marinduque, Philippines. Men and women in costumes and masks replicating the garb of biblical Roman soldiers as interpreted by local folks. Participants reenact the story of Longinus, the half-blind Roman soldier who was present during Jesus' crucifixion. The locals' reenactment of the biblical story climaxes on the Easter Sunday when Longinus is beheaded. This week-long celebration starts on Holy Monday and ends on Easter Sunday. Next is Pahiyas Festival, still in Marinduque Province. Lukban celebrates the Pahiyas Festival in every May 15th in honor of the Saint Patron of Farmers, Saint Isidore the Laborer. Beginning with a 6 a.m. Mass at the Lukban Church, this festival showcases a street of decorated houses. The decoration consists of fruits, vegetables, agricultural products, handicrafts, and keeping, a rice-made decorations which afterwards can be eaten, grilled, or fried. The houses are judged and the best one is proclaimed the winner. Every year, tourists roam the municipality to witness the decorations of houses. Next is Pintados Festival in Tacloban City, Leyte. It is a cultural religious celebration in Tacloban, based on the body painting traditions of the ancient tattooed Pintados warriors. In 1986, the Pintados Foundation Incorporation was formed by the people of Tacloban to organize this festival in honor of the senior Santo Niño. Considered one of the highlights of the festival is the street dancing, where the contingents wear colorful costumes and body paints. The festival also showcases the beauty of its people by organizing a beauty pageant called Miss Teen Pintados. And the last from our list is Mascara Festival in Bacolod City, an annual festival with highlights held every fourth Sunday of October in Bacolod, Philippines. It is the happiest and the most colorful festival in the Philippines. The term mascara was coined from the English word mas, meaning many or multitude of people, and the Spanish word cara, meaning face. Since it is the prominent feature of the festival and are always adorned with smiling faces, giving a rise to Bacolod being called as the City of Smiles.
Hello everyone, I'm Juliana Peralta and I am a reporter for Filipino Values. Values are the integral part in every culture. Values tell people what is good, beneficial, important, useful, beautiful, desirable, constructive, and etc. They answer the question of why people do what they do. So, Filipino values may thrive into many influences. These can be formed from its ancestors or influenced from its colonizers. Some values can be positive or negative. Here are my examples of positive Filipino values. The first one is Bayanihan system or spirit of kinship and camaraderie. A Filipino community spirit and cooperation wherein a group of individuals extend a helping hand without expecting in return. The next one is Damayan system. Sympathy for people who lost their loved ones in case of death of a certain member of the community. The whole community sympathizes with the bereaved family. The next one is familism, or close family relations. A Filipino trait of giving the highest importance to family above other things. Number four, hospitality. A Filipino trait of being receptive and generous to guests. The next is friendly. A trait found in most Filipinos that they are sincere, loyal, kind, and sociable to people. The next one is flexible or madaling makibagay. The ability of Filipinos to ride on or adjust to the norms of other group to attain smooth and harmonious relationships. The example for this is the OFWs. The next one is religious. Most Filipinos possesses strong confidence of other religious beliefs in action and in words. The next one is respect to elders. A Filipino trait of being righteous in both in action and in words to older people. The next one is remedyo attitude. A Filipino trait of being creative and resourceful. It is the ability to do things that are next to impossible. The next one is matyaga. Filipinos are known for their tenacity of strong determination in every undertaking. The last one is utang na loob. A feeling of obligation to repay someone who extended assistance to another, which may take place in undetermined and whatever way. So here are my examples for negative Filipino values. The first one is Filipino time. Also known as always late, is a Filipino attitude of preciseness towards time. The next one is bahala na attitude. A Filipino trait characterized by retreating or withdrawal of certain undertaking, and leaving everything to God to interfere and determine the outcome of his deeds. The next one is euphemism, a Filipino way of substituting a word or phrase that is thought to be offensive or harsh with a mild and acceptable one in order to not offend or hurt another person. The next one is gaya-gaya attitude, a Filipino attitude of imitating or copying the other culture, especially in dressing, language, and fashion. Next one is jackpot mentality, a get-rich-quick mentality of some Filipinos who would rather engage in fast ways of acquiring money than throughout hard work and sacrifice by getting in lottery, joining raffles, raffle draws, and many more. Mañana habit, delaying or setting aside of a certain task assigned on the next day, although it can be done today. Ningas Kogon, being enthusiastic during the start of a new undertaking but ends dismally in accomplishing nothing. The next one is colonial complex or blue seal mentality, a Filipino value of showing high admiration and reverence to foreign produced goods over local ones. The next one is scrub mentality, a Filipino attitude characterized by an attempt to pull down someone who has achieved success beyond the others. The next one is oversensitive. Filipinos have the tendency to be irritated easily or hurt upon hearing some criticisms or comments. Lack of sportsmanship, for not accepting defeat in competition but rather putting the blame either to their opponents or to the sports officials. The last one is chambalang attitude, simplicity by declaring that his or her accomplishments that are result of luck and not from perseverance and ability. So that is all for my report. So God bless everyone.
Hello guys, my name is Franz Bitimtim, BPED student. Today, I will discuss to you the two types of holidays in the Philippines. Let's go!
Regular holidays, January 1, New Year's Day. New Year's is the time or day at which a new calendar's years begin and the calendar's years count, increments by one. Many cultures celebrate the event in some manner, and the first day of January is often marked as national holidays. April 9, Day of Valor or Araw ng Kagitingan. Araw ng Kagitingan, as also known as Bataan Day or Bataan Corridors Day, is a national observance in the Philippines which commemorates the fall of Bataan during the World War II. March 24, or Mauritors Day. Mauritors Day is the Christian holidays falling on the Thursday before Easter. The commemorates the washing of feet and the Last Supper of Jesus Christ with the apostles. As described in the Canonical Gospels, it is the fifth day of Holy Week, preceded by Holy Wednesday and followed by Good Friday. March 25 or Good Friday. Good Friday is a Christian holiday commemorating the crucifixion of Jesus and his death at Calvary. It is observed during Holy Week as a part of Pascha Triduum on the Friday preceding Easter Sunday at may coincide with the Jewish observance of Passover. May 1, Labor Day. Labor Day is an annual holiday to celebrate the achievement of workers. June 12, Independence Day. Independence Day is an annual national holiday in the Philippines observed on June 12, commemorating the celebration of the Philippines' independence from Spain in 1898. July 6,
Eid al-Fitr, also called the Festival of Breaking the Fast, is a religious holiday celebrated by Muslims worldwide that marks the end of the month long down to sunset fasting, the Ramadan. August 29, National Heroes Day. Observed on the last Monday of each August, National Heroes Day commemorates the cry of Ugad Lawin, a revolt that kicked off the 1896 Philippines Revolution against the Spain Empire and the long struggle toward that country independence. September 11, Idul Adha. Idul Adha is the latter of the two Islamic holidays celebrated worldwide each year. November 30, Bonifacio Day. Bonifacio Day is held on November 30, unlike Rizal Day, which is held on death anniversary of Jose Rizal. Bonifacio Day is celebrating on his birth date. December 25, Christmas Day. Christmas is an annual festival commemorating the birth of Jesus Christ, observed preliminary on December 25 as a religious and cultural celebration among billions of people around the world. December 30, Rizal Day. Rizal Day is a Philippine national holiday commemorating the life and work of Jose Rizal, a national hero of the Philippines. Special holidays. February 8, Chinese New Year. Chinese New Year is a Chinese festival that celebrates the beginning of New Year on the traditional Chinese calendar. August 21.
Good day everyone, my name is Mateus Valdesco from VPED 2 and my topic is all about the religion in the Philippines. And here are the three examples of the religions in the Philippines.
Christianity is an Abrahamic monotheistic religion based on the life and teaching of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Its adherents, known as Christians, believe that Jesus is the Christ, whose coming as the Messiah was prophesied in the Hebrew Bible called the Old Testament in Christianity, and chronicled in the New Testament. It is the world's largest religion with about 2.2 billion followers as of 2020. Christianity remains culturally diverse in its Western and Eastern branches, as well as in its doctrine concerning justification and the nature of salvation, exorcology, ordination, and Christology. Their creeds generally hold in common Jesus as Son of God, the Logos incarnated who manifested, suffered, and died on a cross, but rose from the dead for the salvation of mankind, as well referred to as the Gospel, meaning the good news in the Bible. Describing Jesus' life and teaching are the four canonical Gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, with the Jewish Old Testament as the Gospel's respected background. Philippine shamans, commonly known as Babaylan, also Balian or Catalunan among many names, were shamans of various ethnic groups of the pre-colonial Philippine Islands. These shamans specialized in communicating, appeasing, or harnessing the spirit of the dead and the spirit of nature. They were almost always women or feminized men, asog or bayok. They were believed to have spirit guides by which they could contact and interact with the spirits and deities, Anito or Diwata, and the spirit world. Their primary role were as mediums during Pag-Anito Shian's rituals. There were also various subtypes of Babaylan specializing in the art of healing and herbalism, divination, and sorcery. Islam is an Abrahamic monotheistic religion teaching that Muhammad is a messenger of God. It is the world's second largest religion with 1.5 billion followers of 24.5% of the world population. Known as Muslim, Muslims make up a majority of population in 49 countries. Islam teaches that God is merciful, all-powerful, and unique, and has guided mankind through prophets, revealed scriptures, and natural signs. The primary scriptures of Islam are the Quran, believed that the verbatim word of God, as well as the teaching and normative example called the Sunnah, composed of accounts called Hadith of Muhammad. Muslims believe that Islam is the complete and universal version of a primordial faith that was revealed many times before through prophets including Adam, Abraham, Moses, and Jesus. Muslims consider the Quran in Arabic to be the unaltered and final revelation of God. Like other Abrahamic religions, Islam also teaches a final judgment with the righteous rewarded in paradise and the unrighteous punished in hell. Religious concepts and practices include the five pillars of Islam, which are obligatory act of worship as well as following Islamic law, Sharia, which touches on virtually every aspect of life and society, from banking and welfare to women and environment. The cities of Mecca, Medina, and Jerusalem are home the three holy cities of Islam. From a historical point of view, Islam originated in the early 7th century CE in the Iberian Peninsula in Mecca. And by the 8th century, the Umayyad Caliphate extended from Iberia in the west to the Indus River in the east. The Islamic Golden Age refers to the period traditionally dated from the 8th century to the 13th century during the Abbasid Caliphate. When much of the historical Muslim world was experiencing a scientific, economic, and cultural flourishing, the expansion of the Muslim world involved various caliphates and states such as Ottoman Empire, trade, and conversion to Islam by missionary activities.
Thank you for listening, guys. Again, I'm Matthew Valdesco. God bless and keep safe.
So that is the end of our video. Thanks for watching, and there's always a peace.